little booty.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة لا إله إلا الله ودرجنا لي
إن الحمد لله نحمد تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو مهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا واتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا واتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير هدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة وأهلها في النار وعياذ بالله من النار أيها المسلمون My brothers in Islam, I want to talk about something that's very important that we've heard many times. But it's a reminder for myself and my brothers and sisters in Islam. the importance of Islamic knowledge, al-ilm al-nafi', and the reason being we live in a time in great uncertainty, as we know the inauguration, a new president here. So the Muslims in America, we don't know. And likewise, we have fitna and difficulties all around the world in our various countries. But what is the assas that will help us build ourselves? It's ilm al-nafi', that we have to have correct knowledge in order to protect ourselves from fitna, in order to know what to do in times of trial and tribulations. We will never succeed on jahil, on ignorance. And the great Imam Al-Mujaddid, rahimahullah ta'ala, said, اعلم رحمك الله أنه يجب علينا أن تعلم أربع مسائل الأولى العلم وهو معرفة الله ومعرفة النبي ومعرفة الدين الإسلامي بيد الله. So the great Imam, rahmatullah alayhi, rahmatan wasi'ah, he mentioned that it is an obligation upon every Muslim to know some basic things about their religion. He said the first thing is knowledge. The first thing that we need is knowledge. And then he mentioned what he meant by knowledge. He mentioned what is sahih knowledge. Limadha? Because it's in a hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam about the importance of the questions of the grave. And the Imam said, Al-ilm huwa ma'rufat Allah wa ma'rufat al-Nabi wa ma'rufat al-Din al-Islam bi-adillah. He said that knowledge is knowing Allah. That means Tawheedillah, Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah, Tawheed al-Asma'i wa Sifat. To know all of our worship goes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever difficulty you're having in your life, it's reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's tawakkal ala Allah azza wa jal. This is ibadah, and this is from Iman, and this is and requires ilm. And this is the first ilm that you need, the most important ilm you need, which is Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because how can you worship if you don't know who you worship? And then he said the second is Ma'rufat al-Nabi. It's knowing the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Who is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam? We need to know his seerah. We need to know about him salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayhi. So that way, what? We can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala properly. And we can follow his sunnah, but we have to know his sunnah to follow it. And the third type of knowledge he mentioned, which is also what we'll all be asked in the grave, it is knowing the religion of Islam in general, that we have to know. We have to know the types of ibadah that we're going to fulfill. The basic fiqh, the basic how to pray, how to make tahara, how to make zakat if you're ahlan for thalik. You know, how to do the basic aspects of the religion that all of us need to know. So you can practice your religion better. Then he said, athani al-amal bi. So it's not sufficient that you have this knowledge. The second thing is that you have to practice that knowledge. You have to make tatbiq. We have to practice what we know and what we learned. A thalith, a dawah to ilay. Then we give dawah. We give dawah based on what? Ilm and fiqh. Not based on jahil, just going here and there and all around the world, calling people, wanting to call people with khair, with a good niyyah, but without really true knowledge. Wallah mustaan. And the fourth thing he mentioned, after giving dawah, is a sabr ala adhafi, is being patient upon the harm that comes with dawah, because dawah is harmful. And then he said, with dalil, qawluhu ta'ala, wal asr, innal insana lafi khusr, illa alladhina amanu wa amalu salihati wa tawassaw bil haqqi wa tawassaw bil sabr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, by the time, verily mankind is in a loss. If we stop there, we just say khalas. All mankind is in a loss. Illa alladhina amanu. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made istithna. He made an exception. He said, illa alladhina amanu. He said, except those who believe. Ahli iman, that's from us. That's us, bi'idhnillah. Illa alladhina amanu wa amalu salihat, and they do righteous deeds. Wa tawassaw bil haqq, they make da'wah lillah. Wa tawassaw bil sabr, and they're patient upon the harm that it comes with giving da'wah lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because it's a patient path. People will reject you, your family will reject you. People may attack you physically and take your life, as has happened to how many ulama of Ahl Sunnah throughout time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitabi al-kareem, وَمَا كَانُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لِيَنْفِرُوا كَافَةٍ فَلَوْلَا نَفَرَ مِنْ كُلِّ فِرْقَةٍ مِّنْهُمْ طَائِفَةً لِيَتَفَقُوا فِي الدِّينِ لِيَنْذِرُوا قَوْمُهُمْ إِذَا رَجْعُوا إِلَيْهِمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَحْذَرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is not proper for the believers to go out and fight altogether. Out of every troop a party shall go forth, that those who remain receive instructions in deen, and that they may warn their people when they return, so they would be beware of evil. We need ilm. That's the fadl of ilm. That's the benefit of ilm. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى يُرْفَعِ اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He raises Ahl Iman. يُرْفَعِ اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ, and those who are given knowledge, darajat, and that darajat, the raising with through knowledge is in this life as well as the hereafter. For sure in the hereafter, but even in this life, look how many imams. I bet not a house in here does not have Sahih Bukhari. We all mention Sahih Bukhari. We all mention Imam Nawawi, Arba'in Nawawi, Riyadh Salihin. We all read from these books. They're mentioned. Allah has made their dhikr, their remembrance in this dunya. Why? Because they spread ilm and nafiyah. They spread something all of us can benefit from, no matter where we're from. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى وَقُوْ رَبِّي زِدْنِي عِلْمًا. This is a dua. Say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, my Lord, increase my knowledge. Again, the fadl of ilm. We need the knowledge. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِي كِتَابِ الْكَرِيمِ وَتَقُوا اللَّهُ وَيُعَلَّمَكُمُ اللَّهُ. That shows us how to get the knowledge. It's through taqwa. It's through fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتَقُوا اللَّهُ وَيُعَلَّمَكُمُ اللَّهُ. Fear Allah and Allah will teach you. So part of that ilm, ilm al-nafi'ah, is by fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what does taqwa mean? What is taqwa? Taqwa, it means to do the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and avoid the prohibitions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited in the Quran and in the authentic sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِيَ الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Are those who know like those who don't know? فَضْلُ الْعِلْمِ. Because as Imam Ahmed mentioned, that the benefit of the scholar compared to the general Muslim who does all kind of ibadah, the scholar is much greater. Why? لماذا? This one is making qiyam al-layl, this one is doing this, this one is doing this, this one is just teaching. But he's doing the basics and he's doing some extra ibadah. But he's doing it on ilm wa basira. He's doing it on knowledge and basira. Whereas the one who doesn't study at all, that he might fall into all kind of mistakes. And that brings up something we'll talk in the last part of the khutbah about the importance of the two conditions for our deeds to be accepted. قال الله تعالى إنما يخشى من عباده العلماء. Verily, those who fear Allah most is the ulama. It's not just anyone who's memorized. We're not talking about just memorizing. But it's because why? Because they have ilm al-nafi'ah and they practice it. Going back to what we mentioned, that the Sheikh mentioned. It's they have the beneficial knowledge and they practice it. They make tatbik of that knowledge. It's not based on a particular tribe, a particular race, a particular color, a particular this or that, or nationalism. La. It's based on ilm. And it's based on akhwat islamiyah. It's based on the Islamic brotherhood. This is the practice. But unsuriyah and these other things will never benefit us. And they only take us away from ilm sahih and making tatbik of it. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم إن الله وملائكته وأهل السماوات والأرضين حتى النملة في حجرها وحتى الحوت يصلون على معلم الناس الخير. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives barakah and sends the peace and the malaika and everything in the heavens and earth, even the ant in his hole, even the whale in the sea. They supplicate for the one doing talib al-ilm, who's going out in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's khuruj fi sabilillah. It's going out seeking ilm sahih and to give that knowledge, to share that with the people. But ilm sahih, ahabati fillah, it requires, as with everything in Islam, if you want your deeds to be accepted, there are two conditions. And they are sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you have the sincerity, ikhlas, whatever you're doing, whether you're worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it has to be from your heart. It has to be based on tawheed and sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second is what? Mutaba'. It's following the sunnah of who? Muhammad ibn Abdullah, salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayhi. So if you pray with sincerity, fajr, salatul fajr, but you want to add a rakat because you want extra reward, or two rakats because you want extra reward, it will never be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you didn't follow the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Man ahdatha fi amrina hadha ma laysa minhu fa huwa rad." Whoever does something in this affair of ours will have it rejected. So who innovates something in this religion of ours will have it rejected. So if you do something and it's not from the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though you felt it was, it will be rejected. That act of worship will be rejected. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله واتوب إليه. الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. So my brothers, as we mentioned, sincerity is very important. Sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all the worship you do, no matter what. And that goes, and that is even in the highest duties in Islam. Listen to this hadith of Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, when the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, "In al-awwal an-nas yuqda alayhi yawm al-qiyamati rajulun ustushhida. فأتي به فعرفه نعمه فعرفها قال فما عملت فيها قال قتلت فيك حتى استشهد قال كذبت استشهد قال كذبت ولكنك فعلت لي قال هو جريء فقد قيل ثم أمر به فصحب على وجهه حتى ألقى في النار. The first was a man, the Prophet ﷺ said, the first three people who will be judged on the Day of Judgment, the first one is the man who was martyred. And we know that this fi sabilillah is one of the highest things you can do in Islam. So he was brought before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asked, "What did you do?" He said, "I fought for your sake and I was killed." He said, "You lied, but rather you did it so that the people would say that you were brave." And they said it. So then he was ordered to be thrown in the hellfire. وَعِيَّذٍ بِاللَّهِ. And that was the one who's shahada بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ, that the people believe. وَالرَّجُلٌ تَعَلَّمَ الْعِلْمُ وَعَلَّمُهُ وَقَرَى الْقُرْآنِ فَقَالْ وَمَا فَعَلْتْ. هذا بمعنى حديث. قال تعلمت العلم وعلمته وقرأت فيك القرآن قال كذبت ولكنك فعلت ليقال هو عالم وقرأت القرآن ليقال هو قارئ فقد قيل ثم أمر به فسحب على وجهه حتى ألقي في النار. The second one was the person of knowledge, and this is, comes to the shahid of what we're talking about. This is the person of knowledge. We know we love the ulama and we love Sudais, we listen to him, we love all the ulama, the qurra that read the Quran. They teach us how to read the Quran, but they have to have ikhlas lillah. So this person who read the Quran and the alim was brought, will be brought before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask what they did, and then it will be made clear what they did, that they read and they taught the people and they studied ilm, but they did it to be called an alim, and the other one did it to be called a beautiful reciter, and it was said, that means they got the reward in the dunya, and then they're thrown in the nar. وَرَجُلٌ وَعْسَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَيْطَعُهُ مِنْ أَسْنَافِ مَالْ كُلِّ فأتي به فعرفه نعمه فعرفها قال فما عملت فيها قال ما تركت من سبيل أن تهب أن ينفق فيها إلا أنفقت فيها لك قال كذاب ولكنك فعلت لي قال هو جواد فقد قيل ثم أمر به فسحب على وجهه ثم ألقي في النار. So in the last part of the hadith, the third man who is brought before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be brought before Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and ask what he did. And he would say, I spent fi sabilillah, I spent for your sake. And I spent ma taraktu min sabila and tuhibbu an yanfaqa fiha illa anfaqtu fiha lak. I didn't leave any way to spend in your path except that I did it. Meaning he probably built masajid. He did sadaqa jariyah. He did all this khair. He spent his wealth in all this khair. But then it will be said, you lied. But rather you did it so that the people would say you were a philanthropist. And it was said, meaning he got his reward in the dunya. And then he was dragged in the fire. This is to show us, ahabati fillah, that sincerity on this path. What is this relevant for us? Maybe most of us are older. We're not going to be tulab al-ilm now probably. But it's for our children. It's for the raising of our community. Because we know the importance. If we want, just think if we were many in numbers, as the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said in another hadith, but we didn't have ilm amongst our community. What is the benefit? How are we going to deal with the issues that we face? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Man yuridullahu bihi khayran yafaqahu fi din." Whenever Allah wants good for a person, He gives them understanding of the religion. The ulama say, al-mafhum mukhalifa, is that the one who is not given fiqh fi din, that does not improve their Islamic knowledge in some way, they're not receiving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's love. Subhanallah. May Allah protect us from not having His love. Subhanallah. Wa qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, talab al-ilm faridatun ala kulli muslim wa muslima. Seeking knowledge is an obligation upon every Muslim man and Muslim woman. Meaning the knowledge of the wajib. Everyone doesn't have to be an alim. Everyone doesn't have to have fiqh fi biyur necessarily. But they need to know if they're involved in tijara, if they're involved in trade, they need to know the ahkam of that. Of course, everyone makes salat. They need to know how to pray. They need to know how to make tahara. And this shows us also the fadl of ilm from the sunnah. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Man salaka tariqan yaltalimsuhu bihi ilman sahala Allahu lahu tariqan ila jannah." Whoever traverses the path of knowledge, Allah will make easy for him jannah. Don't you want this for your children? Don't we want this for our community? So we need to encourage our children, encourage our families, and try to raise up our children in a house of ilm. Try to feed your soul. Seeking knowledge, for me, it's feeding my soul. Because the less I read the Quran, the less I read the sunnah, my heart becomes darker and it's easy to embrace the dunya. Another important point I want to mention while I have this pulpit, ikhwana fillah, is the importance of knowledge in defending against deviant ideologies. Why? Because look at all the fitna that we receive in this country from people who are extremists who do things in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's deen. They lied. How can they say they do this, blow up this, and they kill this one, and they do this in the name of Allah, in the name of Islam? وَعِيَاذٍ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. Islam is free from this type of sickness and this ailment and this cancer that spreads throughout our communities and throughout the world. But they do exist because they existed after the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. They began with the Khawarij. And what I want to say, the Prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to be one community. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. And hold all of you steadfast to the rope of Allah and do not divide. Meaning we're ordered to be one ummah. One ummah based on what? Based on kitabillah wa sunnat rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam let us know and he prophesied that we would divide. These things would happen. So don't be in denial that it doesn't happen, that we don't have shabab from our community who go to Somalia and join shabab. We do. We have this problem. So you have to teach those youth what is correct. Stay away from ahla bidah wa zandaqa wa ahla deviants. Wa iyadhan billah min that. Because they only cause more fitna for us, more trials upon us when we're trying to reside here and do khair, do da'wah, hopefully, inshallah ta'ala, bi'idhnillah ta'ala. Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Iftarakat al-Yahud ala 72 firqa, wa iftarakat al-Nasara ala 72 firqa, wa sataftariku hadhihi umma ala 73 firqa, kullaha fi an-nar lil wahida. Kullu man hiya ya Rasulullah? Qala man kana ala mithli wa ma kana alayhi wa ashabi al-yawm kama qala nabiyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam." The Prophet said that the ummah would would break into 70, the Jews break into 71 sects. Christians into 72 sects. And my ummah would break into 73 sects. All of them in the fire except one. How could the ummah of Muhammad be in the fire? He said, except one. And they said, who are they, Ya Rasulullah? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, those who are upon my sunnah and the sunnah of my companions. And I'll end with one last hadith that gives us some hope, because I don't want to take your time too much, Ikhwan. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Ma tazal ta'ifatum min ummati dhahirin al-haq, la yudurruhum man khalafahum wa la man khadalahum hatta taqum as-sa'." The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, "There won't cease to be a group from my nation that continues to be on the truth. No one will harm them who differs with them or tries to disagree with them until the hour is established." Imam Bukhari and his sheikh and many of the mufassirin of hadith or ahl hadith, they said, if it is not ahl hadith, I don't know who it is, meaning the people of knowledge. So we need to stick with the people of knowledge, and we need to raise our children to go and study and to come back and bring the knowledge to us. We ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Anything I said that was correct was from Allah Azza wa Jal. Anything I said that was correct, incorrect was from myself and the shaitan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Aqim as-salah.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
Stow sufufukum finna taswiyat sufuf min tamam salat. Straighten your rows, close the gaps, and allow room for our brothers in the back. Bi'idhnillah. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا صراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah. Astaghfirullah. 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 Assalamu alaikum.